my tears have dried. And I know that no weapon formed against me will prosper.
We make it look easy.
And I truly believe that my haters are my motivators.
Your money.
Virtual Balenciaga. with the Kardashians and working out with your child's father. I'm not trying to degrade women. I love y'all. I love y'all. No, really. I love y'all. But first, give us back our credit card. But first, go get a real job. But first, come read this a pen sentence. It ain't that you don't want to, bitch. You can't comprehend it.
Right.
How is it even logical to you to put your Instagram on private? I let morals mold me. So to the women who work hard, don't you ever get discouraged. To those who just lay down, you're already grave ready. I just hope Desana was worth it.
In her eyes, I can see the weakness. In her eyes, I can even see the strength that she can't see, because all she sees is depression. A reflection of how she feels about her lack of perfection. So I just continue to remind her of all of her blessings. Her complexion laced with kisses from God. She's worth more than she understands right now. Look her in her pupils when I do so. And when I hug her, I make sure she can feel the earth underneath us smiling at the stands we took. Gorgeous enough for the both of us, but wasn't told enough that she was a blessing. So I make sure to let her know when I see her. She just looks into my eyes and she swears that I'm kidding, and I swear that she's tripping, because in her eyes, I can see beauty's true definition. Thank you.
You guys already met me. Yeah. I do events around Miami and Broward, and I do graphic design. Basically, I'm the creative director. So, yeah.
Dark side, baby. How y'all doing today? I'm a songwriter, entertainer, artist, apparel maker, boss, owner. I basically do everything. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Tanya D. I have an internet radio talk show called Urban Sweep. I also produce and created Urban Sports Take, which is a sports show for guys. It's a podcast on 247miami.tv.
Real proper, like a poet and moderately successful troll.
Give our judges a round of applause.
All right, I was born in the city where the builders beat down. And if you ain't play sports, then you ain't get out. Each and every day, the guns went up blazing. But the only time I sent shots was with the turning of pages. Established in the year 1990 in Pahokee, Florida. Back in the 80s, those were moms crossed that state border. See, when I was born, the doctor had to thank my moms, because at that very moment, see, he knew a star was born. If I took the time to tell you my story, then you could probably understand why each and every day I gotta thank the man up above and let him know that in my eyes, he's always the man. My favorite candy is Reese's. I just thought that I should mention, growing up, my favorite team was the Detroit Pistons. Woo! I'm the truth. I do my thing. I believe in myself, so I never fall. If you don't like what you see, it's all good, fuck you. I'm the truth, I do my thing, headed to the top. When you meet me though, done.
Be where the poets be, but y'all don't understand. Well, you gotta be intellectual. See, I have a gift from God, but in order to embrace it, I had to be broken. Couldn't speak life if I never lived it. Couldn't find myself if I never lost me. So in order to possess such greatness, it had to cost me. I promised to myself that I will always love you, never hate you. So if I forget to ever thank
you, I will always remember to thank you. My name is Patrick Gregory Zee. Only my mother and I have that last name in our family. See, I never knew my father, but if I did, I would put both hands to his face before my hands met his body with lethal intentions. You don't touch my mother. You lucky you gone out. Woo! It's a religion where pants sagging apparently gave you rights for bragging. Where these little girls give it up so often you can see the cherry stems in the streets. Pop, cock, bang. Bullets scare away the pigs that are supposed to be protecting us from ourselves. Necessary, I'm a black man. Set up to end up in an RIP shirt. I have no history. Or so I thought, until I picked up a book and he spoke to me. Nah, young brother. These are the words coming to you from the doctor, Reverend. Now I have spoken in the Million Man March. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I have spoken in the Million Man justice has tasted persecution. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Your ancestors only hungered for equality. You see, you must understand where you came from to figure out where you're going. You must understand where you came from to figure out where you're going. As Dr. King spoke to me, I read. I learned about kings and queens that shared my pigmentation and gave me pride. I learned that blacks boycotted buses and brushed their butts before breaking through gave me pride. I learned that the universe was black before all else gave me insight. I learned that blacks had butts before Kardashian.
Okay.
Lips before Jolie. And thrust way before Elvis put that thrust in his pelvis gave me insight. I'll no longer entertain guns. My mind is my weapon now. I use it to disarm those who think I gotta talk like this here, walk like this here, and put my hands in an area that's somewhere near.
Okay.
Anybody got time for that? Martin Luther King, Tubman, Tupac Shakur, Malcolm X, Mandela have shown me my legacy. They have molded me better.
But keep in mind that just because I came out tonight, I'm not here to get your feedback or the negativity. I'm here to explain to you why I came out, why my name is Corner Artist. Now, that name might not change, or it might. But just because I came here doesn't mean that I'm not shy. But as the best to me always said, I'm still an artist. Still sensitive about my shit.
Good night.
Allow me to reintroduce myself as El Michelle, spoken word poet and hostess. I'm about to spit some shit, so get ready to toast this. Listen closely for the profound words to roll off my lips. Watch closely how classily I sway my hips. Like staring through the hourglass, don't be wasting my time. Anything I say you like, go ahead and rewind. Kings and queens, we slamming for literacy. If you can't read, you can't write poetry. I'm serious about my poetry, shit. That's the reason why you hearing this. Cause yes, bitch, I suck dick and I solve crimes. I write about real life up in my rhymes. So I'ma get up out of here and let y'all have a good time.
Rewind!
That's the reason why you hearing this. Cause yes, I suck dicks and I solve crimes. I write about real life up in my rhymes. So I'ma get up out of here and let y'all have a good time. And know if you find me dead, I'm a jail. It wasn't death by suicide.
Alright? Pam knows the truth and El Michelle. Alright? That's next round.
Couple slaps to the face, beef arguing with a dude that got a pistol at his waist. And everybody wants to make it into heaven's gate, but if you're praying after you get shot, bro, it might be too late. Oh, we're so worried about the flash and rappers talking about their cash and using their melodic beats to incentivize us like we supposed to be trap queens and sip lean. Can we go back to the days when we're focused on lives rather than shooting them, rather than killing them, rather than booing them?
She said I'm a stripper, and this is my life. I got kids, I'm a wife. So I twist to shake. She shakes until her body breaks. She cries and breaks down, then adds up and breaks down the money she added. To get right back on the job, you would swear she was an addict. She told herself, I'm only finna do this for like a week or two. But if I know her how she know me, then that week or two became a month or three. And that month or three became paid bills, designer purses, Jimmy Choo's, and her own personal army of brothers dying of thirst. And she dresses to expose her soft skin, is soul succulent, sinful, I know, but that body though, body's hoes. As she went from Kinko's to Tootsie's to KOD, she went from the projects and evictions to a modern gated community. Thank you.
Going in, hair weaving, ladies crunch Jordans, Fanny's fresh sticky shorts. And ate them good. EBT cards to buy food to make and sell. Officers in uniforms gliding on a float, can't wait to get off. Same thing every year. Half these niggas out here don't know the fun.
philosophies of Socrates. 50-year-olds explaining how to step on the key. Oh my, oh me, is it lost? Depiction of the addiction of all fake everything. The man stands back and says, that's why you can't give a nigga anything. Ghetto was a word made for Jews, but if you let you read about the Holocaust, it would tell you that. Keep a secret from my people in a book, not in your Barnes and Noble's nook, or 16 bars on one of Drake's hooks. My people search within yourself and tell me, is it lost? Is it lost or is it lost?
I wish you could see how special you are. Skin made of concrete, yet so beautiful and chic. Ride around town, I don't see queens. I'm trying to figure out, is it them or me? Our generation's women into different things. Slight exception for the couple doing big things. The liquor, the gossip, the turn up. Too busy, they ain't got the time to learn us. So we cheat, the power got us turned up. The prison system wait, they been learned us.
What a new black queens. What a new black queens.
The reason I matter is not complex, but if my clothes are too tight, I guess I deserve to be a victim of forced sex or rape or molestation. Imagine being touched without your consent. I was 8. I couldn't do shit. I watched my mama smile and feed 2 kids while my daddy stood in the house with another woman kids and raised them like they were his. I blame America for that. You took the man away from his family so long he forgot to come back. And contrary to what society says I'm supposed to be, let me list all the reasons why they can't fuck with me. I'm black. I'm well educated. Well, technically that's enough. See, you ridiculed me for my ass being fat, but you enjoy white women as long as their qualities are black. Full lips, we want them back. Wide hips, we own that. Ask Kylie Jenner, do she remember the time she had to run a 4 flat in the middle of playtime, or do she remember the time she had to be tender-headed when naps and her mom still yelled, girl, sit back.
Just that all lives that matter are not the ones that scream and don't shoot. So,
America. Why are you keeping up with the Kardashians and making sure they're still credible in Lamar Odom's hospital room? I just want to remind you that black girls, the real black girls, yeah, we still matter too. Thank y'all.
Alright, the winners of the first Slam for Literacy is Daniel.
We've been generally warned, that's what the service says. God talk to me now, this is an emergency. And she claims she only with me for the currency. You cut me deep, bitch, cut me like surgery.
Okay, first and foremost, I would like to thank my mom for birthing me. And chapter 3, my poetry club, they're molding me into a better poet. Thank you, guys.
Have you ever felt you ever want to kill her? And you mix them emotions with tequila. And you mix that with a little bad advice. Someone in them bad nights, you have a bad fight. And you talk about her family, her aunt and shit. And she say, motherfucker, your mama's a bitch.
The first annual Slam for Literacy was an interesting experience. I got to hear poets with different points of views. In every community, not just the black community. Tierra is a great person. She got all us knuckleheads together, and she got us to work out. Somehow, she's just amazing, and her poetry is amazing. I hope to be here again. Yeah, I had a very good time. Thank you.
Just out here at the Slam Literacy the first year. Many more to come. It was very dope. I'm very excited.
Really nice. Really nice. I really enjoyed myself.
I'm ready for next year. It's going to be dope. Shout out to the women.
All right, you guys. My name is Abria, and this was Slam for Literacy. I was the host for the night, and I thank Tierra so much for helping me to be a part of this amazing event. Show love, and we're just showing what's important. The topic was Black Lives Matter, and they really definitely matter tonight.
God, talk to me now. This is an emergency.
You're gonna be the dad for me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.